Droplet precautions are infection control measures that are taken to prevent the spread of diseases that can be transmitted through the droplets of respiratory secretions. This commonly occurs when an infected patient coughs or sneezes. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, transmission-based precautions are used in the hospital for patients with a known or suspected infection that require control measures to prevent it from spreading. The three primary types include contact precautions, droplet precautions, and airborne infection isolation. Each type is classified according to the route of transmission for the disease. However, for this video, we are primarily focusing on diseases that can be transmitted through the droplets of respiratory secretions suspended in the air. Droplet precautions are used to protect patients and medical professionals from the spread of infectious diseases such as the common cold, the flu, pertussis, and diphtheria. This type of infection control requires healthcare personnel and visitors to wear protective masks for each interaction with the patient or their environment. The mask covers the mouth and nose and is helpful in decreasing the spread of organisms from infected patients who produce droplets by coughing or sneezing. The implementation of droplet precautions involves the following steps. First, if possible, place the patient in a private room. Next, you should use special ventilation and air handling if it is available. Then you're going to want to wash your hands before entering the patient's room. Also, wear a surgical mask before entering the room. After caring for and treating the patients, make sure to wash your hands again before leaving the room. As you are leaving, you can remove the surgical mask before leaving the patient's room. Limit patient transport outside of their room if possible. But if transport is required, make sure to have the patient wear a surgical mask because this prevents them from spreading the droplets to other patients or medical professionals. Next, you should use dedicated medical equipment for the patient if possible. But if you can't use dedicated equipment, then make sure to properly clean and disinfect any equipment that has been used by the infected patient. And another important step is to educate the patient and their family about droplet precautions. As previously mentioned, droplet precautions are important in preventing the spread of infectious diseases between patients and healthcare workers. Therefore, all medical personnel must be trained on the proper use of personal protective equipment, aka PPE. This includes when to put on and remove gloves, gowns, and masks before, during, or after each patient interaction. In addition, all medical staff must know how to properly clean and disinfect any equipment or surfaces that may have been contaminated by an isolated patient. It is important to remember that droplet precautions are not a substitute for good hand hygiene. Researchers estimated that 4% of all hospitalized patients in the United States develop a healthcare-associated infection. This refers to an infection that is acquired while receiving treatment for another condition in the healthcare setting. Many cases can be prevented with proper hand hygiene and infection control measures, such as droplet precautions. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.